非常感谢感觉弟兄他这美好的声音啊，带给我们这首美好的诗歌啊，奇异恩典。I'd like to thank Brother Andres through his beautiful voice. He's given us such a classic hymn, Amazing Grace. 你在等 Damien? Samuel 来了。这个直播有时候呢有一些技术的问题，还是要请求我们的技术专家。
Dealt with an urgency. Thank you.
那非常高兴的今天和大家呢我们实体的见面。
Very happy to see you all here again today.
那其实我想口罩也不用戴下了，这个麦克风好像音效还不错哈。
I feel like our technology is also getting better in the sense that the microphones are getting clearer even though we have a mask on.
那今天呢我和大家分享这个信息呢其实是根据高牧师以前呢有讲过这个题目。
So today my message is somewhat of a sequel based on what Pastor Gao has shared with us in his message a couple weeks ago.
所以今天呢我要给大家一个考试哈，就是说这考试关于就是说牧师呢在安息天讲到的题目。
So I would like to give you all a little quiz before we begin today, regarding what Pastor Gao preached about a couple weeks ago.
所以你大家如果还记得吗？就是说无论你在教会或者在网上的，高牧师在4月17号那一天讲到的题目是什么？
No matter if you're at home or if you're right here sitting with us, you're welcome to join in this little quiz. And the quiz question is, what was the title of the sermon presented by Pastor Gao on April the 17th?
请大家回答。
Any idea? I think the answer is already on the board.
So, 那你还记得啊？这个比较深一点咯。
So,
牧师所用的圣经章节是哪一本福音书？哪一章？哪一节？
So this is a slightly more difficult question, and the question is, what Bible verses was used for the scripture reading on that Sabbath? Anyone has any clues?
记得吗？路加福音第十章25到37节哈。
It's Luke chapter 10 verses 25 through 37.
那这里呢就记载了一段故事，就说耶稣基督讲了一个比喻，就讲到这个好撒玛利亚人的比喻。
So I think we're all quite familiar with the story recorded in those passages about the good Samaritan as a parable Jesus gave while he was preaching.
但是在我们还没有跟大家分享信息之前呢，我请大家，我们弟兄姐妹呢，如果圣灵感动你的话，请你呢马上帮助印度。
And before we begin our message today, we really would like to call upon all of us to please make some donations to the country of India if you're able to.
就是我们教会的慈善机构安哲，就是 Adra 它的网站，大家如果就打 ARDA.org 的话呢，你就可以直接呢第一页就可以直接去捐款。
So what was previously shown on the slides on the board was the ADRA, the Adventist Disaster Relief Agency, which is, if you go to their website, adra.org, on the very first webpage, you can see a place for you to make donations for India.
而且呢，在这个网页上呢，如果你捐一块钱的话呢，将会变成3块钱。
And if you make donations currently, there is a matching program where your $1 of donations will be matched to $3.
那昨天下午我在 Adra 的网站看了呢，他们的目标是大概$10,000。
So yesterday I was looking through the Adra website and it looks like their target goal for donations is at $10 million.
所以呢，如果大家捐到1000万的话，就有人认捐，把它加成3倍，就变成3000万。
So if you're able, so if all of us are able to, not, I mean not all of us, if everybody are able to make donations of worth $10 million, then that would be matched to 3 times of that amount, which amounts to $30 million.
所以当作我们在我们的祷告中，我们也纪念这个印度，还有印度的疫情。
So I hope we will also remember India and its current difficult circumstances in your prayers as well.
那同样的，我们在美国这里呢，我们还是要保持这个安全的措施哈，就是口罩不要忘了，还是要记得戴。
And even though we are here in the United States, I do want us to be precautious in all of our actions and do keep in mind.
也要勤洗手啊。
To keep in mind the health and safety guidelines, including wearing our masks when we're outside and washing our hands as frequently as we can.
那还没有接受疫苗接种的话呢，赶快去打疫苗。
And you have not received your vaccination doses yet. I also encourage all of you, to get the vaccination doses as soon as possible.
那我们回到我们今天的这个信息的分享。
So going back to our sermon topic of today.
那就是这个。我们非常熟悉的故事，这个比喻就是好撒玛利亚人。
And it's a parable that we're quite familiar with, the Good Samaritan.
那这个呢，故事呢，比喻呢，也是说到，就是说有一个人在路途上呢，遭到这个强盗的这个杀害谋财。
So the parable is telling us a story of how this man was robbed by a bunch of thieves.
那他被打的这个半死不活的呢，就被强盗们呢丢在路边。
And he was basically harassed, beaten up, and left for dead on the roads.
所以从这里呢，大家可以看到，就是罗马琳达大学医院前面呢，他就把这个好撒玛利亚的这个故事呢，以这个铜像呢展示了出来。
Showing here on the slides is the sculpture garden at the Loma Linda University Hospital, and what we can see is a depiction of the story of the Good Samaritan.
那耶稣就说到呢，这个人被打伤了之后呢，就有一个祭司经过，但是呢却不理睬他，就绕过他的身边往前走。
So after the man was beaten up and basically left for dead, there was a priest who was walking by that area, saw this man, but preferred to just ignore what he has seen.
也许这个祭司很忙啊，他可能有仪式要去赶场，所以呢，他不能停下来帮助这个受伤的人。
Well, maybe this priest was busy going to the next service at the synagogue, so he decided to ignore this helpful man in need on the roads.
过后呢，就一个利未人啊，利未人也是属于祭司级的哈，也经过这地方，看到这个情况呢，也不去伸手帮助。
Then after the priest passed by, the Bible tells us that a Levite was also seen passing by. And if you have a brief understanding of biblical history, you might understand that the Levites were the people of the priests. That's where all the priests came from.
所以呢，他也不伸手去帮助他，也绕过他的身边走了。
So this Levite, after seeing this desperate man in need, also decided to ignore what he sees and just keeps on walking forward.
那耶稣就说，第三位就是一个撒玛利亚人。撒玛利亚人呢是犹太人看不起的一群人。
And after these two men have walked by, then a third man came by, and he was a Samaritan.And according to biblical history, the Samaritan were the people who were belittled by the Jews of those days.
因为他们不是纯正的犹太人，所以没有纯正的这个血统。
As the Jews saw the Samaritans as impure.
所以呢，他们呢是被人家在社会上呢是被犹太人看低的。
So the Samaritans were a belittled group by the Jews.
但是这个撒玛利亚呢，却去帮助了这个受伤的人。他用药把他的伤口包好之后呢，放上他的驴子之后呢，还带他到城里面的旅馆。
However, the good Samaritan had a very kind heart. After he saw this desperate man in need on the road, he decided to apply the medicines he had on his hands, help the man, clean his wounds, and then put the man on his donkey and took him to an inn in the city.
到了旅馆之后呢，还要求这个店主呢照顾他，留下了这个养伤的钱，最后还保证呢，在他回途中呢，如果还有更多的医疗费的话呢，他还会赏还。
So this man went to the inn and paid for the expenses and asked the inn owner to take care of the sick man in need. And the Samaritan promised that if there are additional expenses incurred during his stay here, then after he goes on to his trip and return to the inn, that he will make up for whatever differences there may be.
同样的，当我们听了这个撒玛利亚人的比喻的话，我们成为基督徒呢，我们其实看到。 有需要帮忙的人的话，我们可能都会很乐意的去帮助他们。So
I think the story gives us a quite easy morale in the sense that if we see someone out there that is in need or in need of help, then we as Christians should offer them a helping hand.
那特别是一些比较弱势的，比如说比我们他们的能力或者地位比较差的人呢，我们很自然的，理所当然的去帮他们。
Especially those groups may be less fortunate than us. I believe that from this story we can feel that there is a moral responsibility and a social responsibility for us to offer our helping hand.
那大概五六年前呢，我认识了一位陈先生。
So about 5 or 6 years ago, I met this Mr. Chieng, this person.
Yeah, 他的 first name 是 Willie Tan.
Willie Tan, Mr. Yeah. Willie Tan.
所以应该是潮州人或者是福建人，所以他是姓陈的。Maybe
he is from the province of Fujian, or he is from the city of Chaozhou. So his last name is written in the form of Tan, T-A-N.
那他是属于呢，Fullerton， 我们这里南加一个基督教会的一个平信徒。So
he is a member of a Christian, a generic Christian church in Fullerton here in Southern California.
那他每年呢，他的事工呢，就是每年呢带领的这些医疗的团队啊，到伊拉克去。So
his ministry was about bringing medical teams to the war-stricken country of Iraq.
而且呢，他们去的这个地方呢，就是 Mosul 这个城市。And
the city they would visit in Iraq is the city of Mosul.
而且这 他们去帮助呢这一些叫做雅西里的这些难民，这个雅齐达的这一些一群的难民。And
more specifically, at the city of Mosul, they focused their help to the Yazidi refugees.
这些雅齐达的难民呢，大家如果在几年前你可以看到新闻，他们是受到这个伊拉克这些伊斯兰这个极端这个 ISIS 这个组织的这个迫害。
If you have been following the news over the past couple of years, you may have heard in the news of the religious persecution felt by the Yazidi groups from the hands of extremist Islamic terrorist organizations such as ISIS.
那这些雅齐达的人呢，他们呢多年呢都在中东的地方呢受到这个缠受这些宗教的逼迫，因为呢他们被伊斯兰教呢认为呢他们是拜魔鬼的。
So the Yazidi groups were facing religious persecution by the extremist Islamic terrorist organizations as they were seen as a group that was worshipping Satan.
那以上呢，刚刚这里我们看不到这些图片其实网络上的弟兄姐妹们呢可以看得到，他们在那边呢，除了这个医疗的话，他们还去做布道的这个工作，主要针对呢就是帮助这一些雅西底的难民。
So unfortunately, we are not able to see the pictures on the board right now, but you can also search them up on internet about the pictures of the ministry that this medical team was bringing to Iraq and to the Yazidi refugees. Not only were they providing them with medical help, they were also on a ministerial tour in the sense of sharing the gospel with these refugees.
那 Mosul 呢，可以说是伊拉克呢第二大的城市，位于伊拉克国家的北部，那离这个首都呢巴格达呢大概是400公里。So
Mosul can be said as the second largest city in the country of Iraq and towards the northern borders of the country, and about 400 kilometers away from the nation's capital Baghdad.
而且呢 ，Mosul 呢。 最出名的地方呢，就是有这个尼尼微的古迹的地方。
And Mosul is also the site of the ancient Assyrian capital Nineveh.
我们看不到这个图片哈，其实今天我准备了一些 PowerPoint， 你也看到这个 Mosul 的地方，还有呢，其实在 Mosul 呢，有一个很特别的坟墓。
And unfortunately, due to some technical difficulties, we cannot see the slides and the pictures I have prepared for all of us today. But at the city of Mosul, there is a very special tomb.
大家可以想象到尼尼微跟坟墓，这坟墓是谁的坟墓？
And if you have biblical knowledge, I ask you to guess between the city of Nineveh and a tomb. So whose tomb may this belong to?
答案呢？大家知道答案吗？
Any good guesses? Jonah.
Jonah, 对，约拿，约拿先知的坟墓。
So we believe the tomb belongs to the prophet Jonah.
但是是不是确定的？就说约拿先知是不是在那边埋葬的呢？我们不知道。但是从约拿书这里我们看到约拿呢，他是被上帝呢派到尼尼微去，在那边传道。
Do we actually know if the remains of the prophet Jonah are exactly at where his tomb is meant to be? That question we do not have a clear answer to. However, what we do know is that from the Bible, we do know that the prophet Jonah was sent by God to the city of Nineveh for his mission.
所以先知约拿他的背景呢，是在他是北方以色列国的一个先知，大约呢活在主前786到746年的时候。
So the prophet Jonah was a prophet from the state of Israel at the time, and he lived approximately from the year 786 BC to the year 746 BC.
跟他同时一起做先知的呢，就是有何西亚，还有这个阿摩斯。
At the same time, his contemporary peers included the prophet Hosea and the prophet Amos.
所以呢，在那时候呢，上帝呢就在异象中呢下了一个命令，要约拿呢到尼尼微去传这个悔改的福音。
So Jonah received in a vision a message from God asking him to go to the city of Nineveh to spread a message of repentance.
尼尼微呢，当时呢是这个亚述国的首都。
And Nineveh was the capital of the ancient empire of Assyria.
那在当时候，亚述人呢是一个非常这个凶悍的一个民族哈。
And the Assyrians were great warriors.
而且呢，他们就是会直接的侵略，或者是威胁到当时呢在他们附近的这些邻国，而且呢，特别是以色列国。
And they were seen as a constant military threat towards their neighbors, especially the northern state of Israel at the time.
所以上一季的话，我们在这个学课以赛亚书，我们也读到，而且也看到这个历史。当时候亚述王怎么样，都是一直在威胁这个以色列，对不对？
So if you recall our Sabbath school lessons from the previous quarter in our studies of Isaiah, we could also see that the Assyrians were seen as a constant threat to the Israeli nation at that time.
而且最后呢，亚述呢也是在主前721年呢灭了这个以色列国。
And in the year 720 year BC, the Assyrians did in fact conquer the Israeli nation.
所以呢，这时候呢，约拿接到上帝的命令，说要到尼尼微去。
So Jonah received this message from God asking him to go to Nineveh.
你是约拿的话，上帝的先知，你会怎么做？
If you are in the place of Jonah as a prophet of God in that position, what actions would you do? Take.
你是不是应该就照着上帝的命令，上帝的吩咐，直接到尼尼微去？
Would you really follow God's orders and proceed to go to Nineveh as soon as you can?
你要到你的敌人那边去，传这个悔改的信息，让他们悔改，不然的话呢，上帝就要毁灭他们。
Are you really going to go to Nineveh, this capital city of perhaps your most dangerous enemies, preaching this message of repentance and telling them that if you do not repent, that God will send his wrath and destroy your city?
那同样的，如果是今天的话，上帝说给你一个使命，说你要到中东或者是伊拉克，到 ISIS 占领的 ISIS 现在不存在了，在 ISIS 占领的地方去传基督教，你肯不肯去呢？
In a similar story, as if we called upon all of you today to say God is giving you a mission to go to the Middle East to spread the good news of Jesus Christ to places where extreme Islamic terrorist groups are still present. For example, if you go to the territories of ISIS, which of course ceased to exist a couple years ago, but maybe towards the places where still has the remnant influences of these extreme terrorist groups. And we ask you to go to those places and to preach the good news of Jesus Christ to those people and those places. Would that be a mission that you are willing to take on?
所以我很佩服我这位朋友 Willie Tan 哈，他一年三次到伊拉克去，而且要深入到 ISIS 控制的地方，在 Mosul 这个地方呢，来传道。
So to be honest with you, I have great respect for this man Willie Tan that I have met, for who was very brave and courageous in his mission into the country of Iraq, into the places where it was previously held by these extreme Islamic terrorist organizations in the city of Mosul.
因为我记得他们在布道的时候，有一次呢，他们去的地方已经开始有了战争，那些就战斗机了都来轰炸，所以他们呢其实有一点生命的危险。
As I recall, when one of my conversations with him, that when they were at Iraq one of those years, that war was still going on. So at one of their missions, one day they could hear fighter jets and artillery going by. And it was rather a life-threatening situation that they were in.
陈先生有这个负担，他就遵守上帝的命令，到了伊拉克去。但是约拿呢？他却什么？拒绝上帝的命令，逃亡。
So Mr. Tan felt a call from God to go on this mission to the Middle East into the hearts of these Islamic territories. However, on the contrary, we can compare this experience to that of the prophet Jonah, who was also given a mission by God, but who rather chose to hide and to flee.
所以呢，他就到了海港，坐船要往西方去，一直要走到西班牙去。
So Prophet Jonah decided to go to the port and went on the ship so that he can go as far away as possible to the western direction and maybe to the Spanish peninsula.
而且他上了船了之后呢，把自己躲在这个船舱啊，船的最底下面，希望上帝找不到他。
And he went into the ship and decided to go to the most bottom part of the ship under the waters, hoping that in such depths that God will not find him.
但是终于上帝还是不肯罢休，追上了他。
But what a naive idea, as God is omnipresent and found him.
而且上帝在的时候呢，让这个海风呢卷起来之后，约拿最后没办法就承认说，这一场暴风雨呢，是因为他的原因而引起的。
So God was able to put a big storm in the paths of this ship, and Jonah was finally forced to confront and recognize his mistake and admit to the fact that he, in fact, is the one who is causing all these troubles for everybody else.
但是呢，约拿他还有 lots of tricks in his sleeve 就是他还有很多这个方法，他就叫这些水手呢，他说你把我丢到海里面去吧，就希望他能够在深海里面的淹死了，他就不用到尼尼微去。
So Jonah felt like he still have things up his sleeves, and he told the sailors, okay, well, you know, this big storm is really going to hurt everybody, so maybe you can throw me into the ocean, and maybe I'll just get drowned by the waves, so I don't have to go on this mission to Nineveh.
但是如果上帝的旨意已经定了，你想你会斗赢上帝吗？
But do you really think Jonah has a good chance of defeating God?
所以上帝就派了，这故事告诉说，当时派了一个大鱼，把什么约拿呢吞吃了。
So God sent this huge fish of whales, and the whale swallowed up Jonah into its stomach.
那约拿在大鱼的肚子里面却没有死哈。
And Jonah did not die within the bellies of the fish.
但是他在大鱼的肚子里面呢，怎么样？约拿悔改，许愿，要听从上帝的话。
But he did spend a couple days in the bellies of the fish, and it was a period of great repentance for Jonah.
所以约拿在圣经里面告诉说，他在大鱼的肚子里面三天。
And Jonah spent 3 suffocating days in the bellies of the big fish.
他悔改了之后呢，上帝就吩咐这个鱼呢，把它吐在旱地上。
After Jonah had a renewed understanding of himself and was humbly repented in front of God, and then God ordered the fish to spit out Jonah.
那上帝呢，在下一次的命令，这是第二次的命令，还是要他到尼尼微去。
After the fish spit out Jonah onto dry land, then God gave the prophet Jonah orders again, telling him to go to Nineveh and spread this gospel, spread this message of a repentance.
所以这个故事的结局大家都知道，那就是应该是一个好的结果哈。尼尼微城怎么样？听到了上帝的福音，悔改的福音，全城悔改。
And I am sure most of you do know the happy ending to the story, that after Jonah went into the city of Nineveh and preached this gospel of repentance, that the city did repent and the city was spared.
但是从这个故事呢，约拿的故事告诉我们什么？我们能够学到什么？
From the story of Jonah, what morals can we take from it?
第一，我们知道神是公义的神，他必施行审判。
One, we know that our God is a fair and just God, and he will deliver justice.
所以当人犯罪，就像尼尼微这个人呢，这个亚述人，他们的罪恶已经到天都不能容忍的时候，上帝要施行审判。
So we know that God is a just God because when the sins of the city of Nineveh has gotten so out of line and so outrageous that God will send them a message of warning.
我想现代的同样的就是说，比如说这个 ISIS 这个恐怖分子被消灭之后，我们大家怎么样都会拍手高声的欢叫。
And I think similarly in our context today, when the extreme terrorist organizations such as ISIS gets decimated, that we are all rejoicing in our hearts for their disappearance.
但是呢，相反的，神虽然是公义的神，施行审判的神，但是他却有什么慈悲的心。
On the flip side, we can also see that God is a graceful God.
而且呢，他为了要拯救尼尼微亚述人不得到灭亡的话呢，他派了他的先知约拿去那边去传这个悔改的福音。
And God wanted to save the people of Nineveh from their sins, and he did send in his prophet Jonah into the city of Nineveh in the hopes of that they will recognize their sins and they may repent.
所以在圣经里面我们看到，特别是在旧约圣经，上帝很多时候呢都晓谕许多的先知啊，到最后就像我们今天所读的学科一样，耶稣基督上帝的儿子来到这个世上。
So in the Old Testament we have many many stories of how God was sending his prophets to deliver this message of warning towards the people. And as we have also earlier talked about today, that God also sent his son, Jesus Christ, to come into this world to give us this special message as well.
所以这个恩典的约就在耶稣的身上实现。
And we can see that this promise of grace was fulfilled by Jesus Christ when he came down to this earth.
所以如果人就像这个尼尼微城，如果接受上帝的恩典，接受主耶稣基督的话，怎么样？他们悔改之后就得永生。
So even though we may have a sinful nature, as long as we are able to hear out this message of repentance and come to realize our mistakes and are willing to humbly repent, then through the grace and the salvation of Jesus Christ, then we are given a second chance and we are able to have salvation.
但是约拿书的结果，就是这个作者呢，就没有把故事就在尼尼微城悔改了之后就结束了，反而却说去了，更继续了说了下面一段。
So you may think that the story of Jonah finished when the city of Nineveh repented, but whoever the author of the book of Jonah is decided to give us the sequel to the story.
就发现呢，约拿呢，就坐在尼尼微城外面。
So Jonah, after preaching this message of repentance, went up the hills and wanted to see how God will destroy the city.
他一直等待,
he went up the mountains hoping for a good show, God had other plans, and God did not destroy the city.
所以这个故事的最后的这一个结局呢，告诉我们说，其实真正去爱你的敌人是非常困难的。And
I think the another moral of the story from the book of Jonah is to truly, truly love your enemies is in fact a rather difficult task for all of us in reality.
就像我们回到耶稣基督这个好撒玛利亚人的比喻。
Going back to the story of the Good Samaritan,
也是说你去爱一个受伤的人，去爱一个比你弱的人， 这是很容易的事情。
And the story Jesus was telling us is perhaps it may be easy for us to share our kindness and to be helpful to those who are less fortunate compared to us.
甚至保罗说，你为一个义人而失去你的生命，这也是可以做得到。
And Paul even said in the Bible that if we are if we lose our lives for a man who we consider to be just, then we may feel that that is worthy.
但是为一个罪人而死，你愿意吗？
However, what if that person we feel is a sinner? Will we be willing to do that?
也是说，你要爱你的。
Jesus told us that we need to love our enemies.
也是说，只是我在马太福音第五章这里说，只是我告诉你们，要爱你们的仇敌，为那逼迫你们的祷告。So
Jesus told us in Matthew chapter 5 verse 44 to love your enemies and to bless those who curse you.
就好像高牧师在两个礼拜前他证道的时候告诉我们他其中一个他所经过的经验，不知道大家还记不记得。And
I'm not sure if you recall the experience Pastor Gao shared with us a couple of weeks ago in his sermon.
那就是星期五晚上诗班练习了之后，大概十一点了吧，十点多十一点了。
And to give you a brief recap of the story, it was a Friday night after the church choir has finished practicing.
牧师正要离开回家的时候，我想大家也都很累了。正要关铁门的时候，一辆车子开到我们车，停在我们的教会停车场里面。
And after church choir practice was over, I believe everyone was exhausted and wanted to go home. But just as they were about to close the gate and leave, a car drove into our church's parking lot.
然后这个车子就停下来了，没电了，需要帮助。
And this church, this car stopped functioning, just broke down and needed help.
所以牧师在他正道说那时候告诉我们说他的心情也不是说很愿意的要去帮助这个人因为他一定急着想要先回家
and the pastor at the time felt a great urgency to go home and didn't really felt that this man is in need of help
所以我们爱人我们爱我们的邻舍的话是不是在我们方便的时候才去爱他们呢
So when we say that we are to love our neighbors, do we only do so when it is of a convenience to us?
我们可不可以去爱那些不可能被爱的人呢?
Can we love those whom it may be even impossible for us to love?
不值得我们去同情他的人呢?
Or maybe those who we may feel that they are not worthy for us to sympathize with.
或者是被人看不起的人。
Or those who are belittled by others.
耶稣怎么说呢？如果你只请你弟兄的安，有什么长处呢？
And what did Jesus tell us? If you only greet your brothers, only those who you like, then what good are you doing than others?
如果你们只单爱那些爱你们的人，有什么赏赐呢？
If you only love those who love you, then what reward will you get?
所以今天我们来讲这个故事的话，其实在这个故事里面呢，耶稣在讲这个比喻之前，就有一个律法师来问耶稣。
So even before Jesus told this parable, a man of the law came to test Jesus.
他就问了耶稣两个问题。
And he asked Jesus two questions.
第一个问题是说，我怎么做才能得到永生？
So the first question this man, this lawyer asked Jesus is, what can I do to gain eternal life?
那耶稣没有直接回答的问题，却问他说，你是读上帝律法的，你是律法师，那律法书上面写的是什么？
See, Jesus did not answer this question directly, and he proposed a counter question to this man and he said you are a man of the law so I am sure that you are familiar with the books of the Bibles and the laws that it has written out so what does that say
那个律法师就回答说你要尽心尽性尽力尽意爱主你的上帝
So the man replied at ease and said oh you know we should love God with all your heart
而且呢，也要爱你的邻舍如同自己。
And you should love your neighbors as yourself.
那耶稣就回答说：“你说的对，你就照这样子行，就得永生了。”
And Jesus said, "Well, there you go. You know the correct answer already. So just do that, and you will have eternal life."
其实得永生就不是只是靠守上帝的诫命吗？
So the question is eternal life merely following the rules?
所以你想，我想这个律法师他可能是一个很虔诚的犹太教教徒。
So this man of the law, he may be a rather pious person.
他可能像法利赛人会禁食祷告，严守安息日，而且呢遵守摩西律法书和他们中犹太教的这些口传的教规。
He may be a man of good faith in the sense that he is following all the things he should do as a good Jew. He may be followed the fastings of the Pharisees, etc.
也许呢，他希望来到耶稣的面前，让耶稣呢能够认同他所做的是对的。
So perhaps he came to Jesus to seek confirmation that what he has been doing is correct.
所以他很骄傲地在耶稣面前说，这些我都做到了。
So the man replied very, very proudly that what you have said, I have already done.
但是呢，他还要反驳耶稣说，再问耶稣第二个问题。
But he was not done with his questioning of Jesus, and he decided to follow up and ask a second question.
谁是我的邻舍？
And who is my neighbor?
谁是我们的邻舍？
Who is my neighbor?
你很自然的可以去爱所应该爱的人。
It may be easy for you to love those people who you feel like they deserve to be loved.
我们会不会去爱那些不可能被爱的人？
Will we love those people who we may feel that it is impossible for us to share our love with them?
耶稣吩咐我们说，你们要爱你的仇敌。
Jesus told us that we needed to love even our enemies.
我们的仇敌是不是那些要杀害我们的人呢？
Are our enemies necessary the people who are out there wanting our lives?
也许是我们的仇敌很有可能是不愿意和我们到教会来的亲友呢？
Our enemies may even be those people who maybe our friends or our family members who do not want to come to church with us.
也许我们的仇敌就是那些不愿意接受真理的，不愿意接受耶稣基督的呢。
Maybe our enemies of those are those people who share a different faith than us. Those people who may be stubborn and not willing to accept the salvation of Jesus Christ.
也许我们的敌人很有可能，就像在我诊所前面有一个乞丐。
Our enemies may be, you know, for example, there's this beggar in front of my medical office, doctor's office.
有时候我会给他一点钱。
Sometimes I would give this man some money.
有时候我经过的时候，我觉得他很烦。我已经给你那么多次，你还在这里讨钱，这次我不给你了。
Sometimes when I see the man, I feel annoyed. I feel, you know, I've given you so much money already. What are you doing here, wanting more?
有一天我就去问他，你为什么会变成一个乞丐？
So one day I decided to talk to him and I asked him, why have you become a beggar?
他说他以前是开赛车的。
So he told me that before he was a race car driver, Formula One.
NASCAR driver.
NASCAR, there you go.
Yeah. 就是因为有一次车祸呢，他断了一只腿。
But because one time in a car accident, he broke his leg.
所以呢，他失去了工作。
And he lost his job.
也不能，也没有钱。
And he did not have money or income.
那每个月政府给他的残废金呢，他不够生活。
And the disability insurance provided by the United States government was insufficient for his livelihood.
他说他有钱的时候呢，他就去住旅馆，一天晚上也要65块钱。
When he was wealthy, he would go into, you know, live in hotels, costing him $65 a night.
当他的钱用完了，他就睡在街边。
Sorry.
When he's run out of money, he will be homeless. Yeah.
Yeah. There you go.
So when he runs out of money, he'll be homeless. 所以呢，有时候呢，他就会在我们诊所附近，在邮政局前面呢，向人讨钱。
So because he has no reliable source of income, then he would just hobble around the city and try to beg for money.
所以有时候我会想到说，有时候我会给他5块钱、10块钱，有一次甚至我给了他50块钱。
So sometimes I would feel kind and give him $5, $10, and one time even $50.
但是有一半的时间，我却看着他，我却不要睬，也不要去理睬他，也不要直接看着他。
But other times I feel less kind and I just felt annoyed that this guy is in front of my office, so I'll just try to ignore him and walk past him without noting his presence.
有时候我会用很冷的话语对他说，我今天不给你钱了。
And sometimes I may be even unkind and tell him that I'm not giving you money today.
他值不值得我们去爱？
Does he deserve our love?
也是说要爱你的仇敌。
Jesus told us to love our enemies?
谁是我们的仇敌？
And who are our enemies?
再深一层的话，谁是上帝的仇敌？
And to go even deeper than that, who is an enemy of God?
这个值得我们思想的，我们去思考的问题。
And I believe it's a good question for us to ponder upon.
所以今天我们是讲说谁是你的邻舍第二讲，希望我们在接下来有第三讲。
So today we continued our series on who is my neighbor, and we hope there will be a third part to this series.
所以希望我们今天下午我们回去说，我们思想说，我们如何去爱我们的仇敌。
So I hope today when we go home that we may consider the question, not only how should we love our neighbors, but also how should we love our enemies.
因为耶稣在登山宝训那里告诉我们说，最后耶稣说，你们要完全像你们的天父一样。
Because in the Bible, at the end of the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus did tell us,that we shall be perfect, just as how your Father in heaven is perfect.
耶稣说最后一句话，前面两句话就是说，你们要爱你的仇敌。
And what did Jesus say before that? Jesus told people that you need to love your enemies.
我相信，如果我们有耶稣基督的爱，能够爱我们的仇敌之后，我们才能够完全的像天父一样。
And I believe it is only when we learn to love those who may think are impossible to love and to really let ourselves go and to love our enemies, then we have become more perfect as our Heavenly Father.
所以在我们的基督徒的生活中，我们会遇到许多所谓的仇敌。
In our daily lives of, as a Christian, we will meet a lot of enemies.
我们有没有用耶稣基督的爱去对待他们？
Are we really treating them with the love of Jesus Christ?
这是我们值得去思考的问题。
And I hope that is a question that you may take with you today.
希望大家，牧师再请我讲第三次。谢谢大家。
Thank you.